start off with, like, you know, maybe like health and wellness. Like, maybe what are some of your earliest kind of memories with health and wellness, like, kind of growing up?
See, I was born in Hawaii, so I was a beach girl, and I remember lots of fruit and lots of everything fresh and beautiful, and going up to the porch, lanai, they call it, in Hawaii, where we pick the fresh papayas from the tree every morning and have that. So that was one of my first little memories as being a little girl, and the fresh fruit.
Wow.
And just how good we all felt. And my father was a big surfer. My two big brothers were big surfers. My mom was this gorgeous creature, and we just had a very healthy lifestyle, healthy looking family. Everyone's on the beach, and everyone's, you know, running around, just feeling good. And so that was one of my first memories, probably almost like 2 years old.
And so, how did you go from kind of Hawaii to here? What kind of brought you to
that? Crazy. I know. What the heck was I thinking? I know. No, my father was a Navy SEAL. And we moved from Hawaii, unfortunately, to Virginia Beach. I love Virginia Beach, but it was brutal because we moved from Hawaii to Virginia Beach in the winter. So I never saw snow. I was freezing. But I obviously love it here. Been here ever since.
Nice.
Yeah.
And so, you know, kind of fast forward, you know, you work in this industry where, you know, you kind of had early exposure to it, kind of as a child. Like, what was, like, your career path, and, like, what did you study in school?
So, you know what, I was actually an art major, and I was a sculptor, did welding, and did big tables.
Oh,
and
I could see that.
And I loved it. I went to VCU, Virginia Commonwealth University of Richmond. It was just one of the best art schools on the planet. I loved it, but it wasn't feeding me fully. Something was missing, and I got my degree, and that felt good. But long story short, really, is my parents, after 40 years of marriage, they split. And that was very, obviously, very stressful. And I was always a thin, athletic girl. Never had to worry about my weight. Was in my bikini, could run around, feel good, everything was fine. But also, when my parents split, I gained a lot of weight very quickly. I started to lose my hair. I had weird rashes on my skin. I had a very bloated, distended belly, and all of a sudden, you know, I'm in my 20s, and I can't go to the beach with my girlfriends. I'm very self-conscious of my body. I felt very unattractive. I really was depressed, and I internalized everything from my parents' split. We were such a half-happy, healthy, you know, unit, and then all of a sudden, bam, you know, they split, and it was amazing what happened, because I started to lose control of the health of my body. My body started to decline, and very quickly. And I gained almost 30 pounds in like 60 some days. And it was a lot of water weight and distended belly, and, you know, just food not being digested properly. So I was going to put on medication. The doctors wanted I should do surgery on part of my intestinal tract. And I said, I can't do this. I gotta get off the medicine. So I went to a Barnes & Noble's back in the day, and I sat there and read every single thing I could on health and nutrition. Everything. For like 2-3 weeks, sat there just ferociously, just absorbing every single thing on nutrition, and I started to change my body. And literally within 2-3 weeks, I started to lose weight, my rash went away, eventually I lost all the weight. It happened very quickly, so it made me a believer about health and nutrition. So it became such a passion of me, and went back to school. So I already had a Bachelor of Fine Arts with an art degree, and then I went and got an associate's degree, a dietetics degree, and then I went to get my master's in health science. And it's been going 20 some years now. It's incredible.
So yeah. Did you ever work for, like, maybe, company, like, do you ever work for anything in the health or fitness space, or did you set out, like, pretty much straight out of the gate and just jumped in?
I mean, I worked for this, actually it's kind of funny, this is so long ago, it was a hypnosis place for weight loss, and I worked there literally as a secretary, and I was very young, and the people there, the health instructors, they taught me so much, and I was already getting involved in nutrition, but that made me really go back to school, and that launched me. So it's always been self-employed, my little baby, the entire time. And
wow.
I've never advertised, I've just kind of generated, and you know, work with a mother, and then she tells her sister, and then, you know, they tell so-and-so. It's been nice just to generate a nice web of health that way.
For sure.
Yeah.
So the word of mouth and kind of like organic kind of marketing, mm-hmm. or, you know, not even marketing, really just kind of doing a good job for clients, yeah. kind of gets the word out. That's impressive. So
that's kind of what you know, the word of mouth is here. You know, just like people are like, oh, where's that bag from? I love that bag. And you're like, well, it's right here. And that's what I like, is generating it with your own just goodness.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You know, I think we try to think too, like, you know, what's going to be like remarkable as possible? You know, what kind of things mm-hmm. are, you know, what kind of fits within like where the consumer attention already is? Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's definitely, it's a fine balance, you know, in our product because there's so much competition.
Yes.
But no, that's really amazing. So, I guess maybe talk about like what you do for clients and like how you work and, you know, what's a typical day.
So it's so nice being self-employed because I can make my schedule, which is lovely. I did the 9-to-5 thing for a long time, even if it was with health and nutrition. I worked in that company, hypnosis. But I absolutely love that I'm able to just schedule my day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, wake up when I want, or, you know, I still have to wake up early for the children. But so my day is I have usually 2 to 3 clients a day, Monday through Friday. Sometimes I work on the weekends. But I'll get up and I love my matcha tea. This is my matcha. I love matcha. Matcha is green tea on steroids.
Mm-hmm.
The benefits of the antioxidants are triple fold. So I start my day off with matcha, and that's it helps you to produce more theanine, to relax you, but also not give you that jitter thing, what's going on with coffee sometimes. I do a little coffee sometimes too, but so my day usually consists of, you know, doing something like that. I do like to meditate. I find that I have to drag myself to go meditate. Literally, I'm dragging my feet almost like a little kid. But once I get to my space and meditate, then it completely, my whole world opens up to, like, I feel so much better.
How long are you meditating on? Are you, you know, just like short or long meditation?
I try and do at least 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
I find that there's more magic when I have a timer that goes 15 to 20 minutes. If it's 5 minutes, that's a good, I feel like it's more of a prayer type of thing where I'm just sending attention to the day, but when you go a little longer and deeper, it really kind of sets the tone for absorbing more miracles, not to get too woo-woo, but just really absorbing more goodness. There's something about it. And the discipline is so important. And I've certainly, again, I can drag my feet. There's always excuses. You know, I'm not going to have special needs 10-year-old child. There's always excuses for being too busy or caretaking to him, but if I don't take, obviously, it's a cliche to say, if you don't take care of yourself, you know, the rest are going to suffer. So you have to take care of yourself first, obviously. But my day, you know, meditate, I try and work out in the morning, but if not, I have 2 to 3 clients, and I'll meet with the client. I love meeting face-to-face, but I do have FaceTime, I'll do other things too with them, but face-to-face really feeds my soul, like really being with them. It's at least an hour of me going over their diet, what they're eating, getting their medications, get their supplements, what they're doing. And I don't want to completely change every single thing the person's in the person's life because it rocks them too much. I just give, what I like to do is gently give them tips of try this in the morning. Let's do some lemon water first thing in the morning to flush your liver. Your liver, the health of your liver determines really everything about your health. If your liver is sluggish, you don't care if you're 15 or you're 95, the state of your liver is really everything. So you gotta keep your liver happy. So lemon water, I know I've been doing it for years, but that's a big, big step for people.
How many lemons?
I like one whole lemon with almost a liter of water to really flush the bile from the liver, to give it a good flush, to be able to push all the gunk out. Even if you're organic, plant-based eater, and you're healthy and you're eating right, just in today's society, today's world, you know, just everything with the pollution, the toxins, the air, the water, we have to detox every single day. That's my, I work with my clients that way, and I love it. And I really look at what they're doing, at individualized plans with everybody. I want to not just say, you do this and this and this, and write everyone to kind of the same diet plan. That works for some, and I don't count calories. I have no idea on the earthly God, you know, plane how much calories I have in a day. and I think that will drive you nutty. So I really just eat to feed my soul and to feed my body and to feel what's right. And that's also, that's why I like meeting with clients one-on-one, because I really can kind of, I feel like I can kind of feel what they, maybe resonates with them best, and then go from there. So it's a blessing what I do. I meet with them and then I'll come home and I'll look over the notes that I took and then come back a few days later with an email of every single thing that we talked about, the specific supplements I want you to take, and give you the, I want you to do this for water, and I like to do this, for breakfast, or, give you a couple options for everything.
How about technology? Do you use any apps or any websites or anything to kind of help you stay organized, help you kind of track? I know there's things you can put points into
There's MyFitnessPal. I know people like that. I don't use that personally with my clients, but I will certainly friend them on that if they want me to follow them that way. I do certainly do that. But I really, what I like for my clients is I tell them, I just like to be in touch with you. It depends on what kind of program you do. But if you want to be every single day, I give you your email, and you email me or text me your food log of the day, and I can calculate what you need and don't need. But the websites, there's so many out there. It's just incredible. Depends on, again, if the person is plant-based or they want to be paleo or where they kind of go. I can gear it to certain apps and certain websites. But I really like to free float it, and not have too much structure, but not too much on them, just so you can kind of just gear it to what they need.
Do you have any mentors or anyone that you kind of seek out, maybe advice or anything like that? Do you have any people that you kind of look up to?
My first person that really got me on the path was Dr. Andrew Weil. He's an old guy. I think he's passed away. He's a medical doctor, but he was very holistic, and I think he was Buddhist. I'm not quite sure. Don't quote me on that. But he was, or certainly lived a Buddhist life. He just ate clean and sensible. That was my first guy to kind of go on the track there. There's so many wonderful people out right now. All the people that I can think about, but he was a big one for me. He was a big influencer. He really was.
What have you kind of learned, about yourself, maybe by being in business for yourself? Is anything, have you had any challenges, or has it pretty much been steady?
It's funny. I made a big business change about 2 years ago. I hired an assistant, basically, or a manager of my media and manager of the business side of things. I realized that me being the creative, artsy kind of girl that I was, I didn't like in the business side of things. I felt that drained me, and it took away from my, the goodness of my meeting with my clients and all that juicy, good, creative flow. I felt like it kind of zapped it. So I went out and said, I'm gonna spend some money on a person that can help me. And she's helped me create a better website and things that I needed just to keep up to date and in the flow, but she saved my life. Emily is my guru.
Awesome.
Yeah. She's incredible. So that's helped me tremendously.
How do you meet Emily?
She was a manager at Fruitive, the plant bar, the plant-based incredible restaurant that I'm a part of. She was not working in the restaurant part, she was working in the business aspect, and she was with the owner. Again, I met her and I said, I'm going to hire her one day. And my husband at the time was like, we can't afford that. That's going to be too much. Lots of people blocking that. Even my family members like, you can't. That's too expensive. You just have to make your own website, do your thing. But I remember in my head meeting her going, she's incredible. I need someone like that. You want someone around you. You always people who are almost smarter than you. You know what I mean? So she's incredible. And that helps me. And that also, we feed off each other. So I'll have an idea, and she'll have an idea. It's just fun to go back and forth with each other. So she is a lifesaver. So that was a big thing for me on my own to say, I'm going to invest in myself in this business. And it's grown incredibly much more from what she's done with me.
How about just 2019 alone? Any takeaways or just key thoughts or themes?
What I think is that 2019, I think everyone has to detoxify. And that sounds kind of silly again, but it's about, back in the day, I used to do cleansers with people, and I still do, of course, but I was doing them seasonally. I'd say, okay, let's go on a liver cleanse this winter. I still do that, and I still promote that. But I really believe in people having to detoxify every single day in today's world. I think most people are extremely, extremely dehydrated, and it's a cellular dehydration, and it's critical. It's critical mass. It really is critical. People are waking up in the morning, and they have a cup of coffee, and then they have an egg sandwich, and then they might have iced tea with lunch, and then they have another cup of coffee, and they might have a little bit of water here and there, but not enough. So people are severely dehydrated, and that's extremely acidic. And disease lives in an acidic state. And it lets, you know, an alkaline state is where you thrive. So being hydrated, especially with lemon water, at least once, twice a day, the lemon helps with detoxifying. That's my biggest theme for 2019, was just detoxify, clean your body. I always look at your body as like a body of water. You can have it as a lake, kind of stagnant, you know, or a pond, you know, kind of stagnant, or you want it to be a stream. You want it to be flowing beautifully. Be able, you know, clean your blood. Most people walk around with thick, dirty, stagnant blood, and that causes issues. You know, you always people taking Coumadin blood thinners and such to thin the blood. You do it naturally with water. You just hydrate the heck out of yourself. You don't have to drown yourself in the bathroom all day long. But the timing is key. When you wake up in the morning, you have a half a liter or a liter of water before you have breakfast. And that's a lot, yes, but I really am a believer that will do a lot beautiful goodness for your liver. And that will flush things out. So that's my thing. Get the kids to do a trot in that. You know, getting your children, I think, to wake up and have a good glass of milk, or I think it's incredible to start your kids, like, everyone have a glass of lemon water. What I do in the family, and my daughter, finally, Olivia, she's 19, and I was like, I made it every day. This has been 10 years plus. I take a big pitcher of lemon water the night before, and I have to stick it in the fridge. And everybody, when they have breakfast, has to get their glass of water. And she's like, Mom. But now she is off to college in Arizona, and she does it herself. I think most days, not every day, but she's gotten in the habit. And that makes my mommy heart happy that I've instilled that with her.
It's good habits going on.
Yes.
Good behavior. What's the best part of your work? Like, what gets you up in the morning?
You know, I have to say, the reactions and the goodness from my clients when I meet with them first face, and I've got people who say I've lost 60 pounds, or I've lost 6 pounds, or I just have more energy, and thank you so much, I've gotten the MSG out of my diet, or I've lost my cellulite, or I've lost my husband doesn't have any glove handles anymore, and little things like that, or bigger changes where you're helping them with cancer treatments, or you're helping them stay disease free, where they've had it in their family line forever, and working on doing green juices every day, and doing alkaline, well, you know, doing lemon water, and they're doing more plant based, not so much meat every single day. So it's little changes like that. It's fun to see people a year later and they look brighter and thinner and more fit, mm-hmm. No doubt.
For sure.
Yeah.
I'm jumping around a little bit.
Okay.
We were talking a little bit about like social media, a little bit of business. I guess my question is, from a social media standpoint, like, what are you doing? Are you, kind of putting out content around, you know, these things? Are you kind of, how do you think about like how social media is impacting your company?
Oh, it's been great. I have to say that it reaches my Instagram and you know, Facebook and, you know, all of it. Has been wonderful. I work with a gentleman in Australia. I work with a man in New York City. I've got people in California and really all over the place. And then I'm moving to Bali in literally a week for 6 months with my youngest child. And I'll be FaceTiming and working WhatsApp and certainly, you know, posting everything and working with my clients 12-hour difference. So I'll be working at my 8 in the morning or their 8 at night or whatever it is, or 6 in the morning. But thank God for social media, and thank God that technology, I'm able to work with my clients. And some of my clients are like, what, you can't go to Bali?
Yeah.
Oh, no way.
That's exciting. What inspired the Bali?
So I have two brothers, and I've got my middle brother, he moved out there from New York City with his family, and there's a green school, they call it. It's absolutely an incredible, wonderful school, all made from bamboo, you should look it up. The green school is quite phenomenal. It's beautiful, and they just transformed themselves. They transformed their lives. They still, again, he's a big photographer. My sister-in-law is an agent for photographers in New York City, Sarah Laird, and they can still do all their work and then some, even from Bali. So I decided, going through a divorce, I decided to change my life. It's a little scary. I feel like, literally, I'm driving here today to meet with you. I felt like I'm on the side of the cliff. And I'm like, ooh, I'm nervous. I'm taking my child. I'm leaving my cat. I'm leaving my house for 6 months. But I'm going to jump, and we'll see where I land. But I know that I'll still, thank gosh, I'll be working in this field and working with my clients still here, but also in Bali. And Bali's magical. The spiritual juju there is deep. It's just a healthy, beautiful environment, all the fresh fruit. I was looking online of grocery stores and things in Bali near my where I'm gonna live, and everything's just fresh, gorgeous, and, you know, and just dragon fruit and all these, the incredible, fruits we don't get here, really.
That's so cool.
Yeah, I'm excited.
So you're gonna go to Bali 6 months. You know, I think what I was having was that, you know, we always stretch in these kind of times where we're going into something that's like new and different or unknown. Uh-huh. So, you know, there's a lot of power there.
Yeah.
So I guess from kind of tying it all in, I mean, you know, what are you like kind of most excited about? Like, what do you kind of hope to gain, I guess, from the experience? Like, do you have any set New Year's resolution at all?
Not yet. I was going to write my journal tonight, the next couple days. Really, it's moving to Bali is obviously going to shift a lot for me. But I know that my core root is nutrition. I'll still be obviously just doing the exact same thing, but I'll be learning from hopefully some locals out there or anyone in Bali, really, with acupuncture, herbs, and some different modalities that I just can play with when I come back here, if I come back. I know I won't come back, but so I'm excited about that. I'm excited because it's a whole new world out there, really is. So I'm just gonna I'm gonna soak it up. I need a few weeks, I think, when I get there, just to get acclimated, and I'm gonna do a lot of meditation. I'm meditating and really kind of grounding myself to feel the love of Bali for a little while, for the beginning especially. And then we'll put my tentacles out and see what happens.
And then I'm going to jump around a little bit again. How did you first kind of get introduced to Fruitive, and how did you have that relationship start?
You know, I was driving by Hilltop, and we're close to where I live, and I saw the name, and I saw, and also one of my girlfriends, oh my gosh, Jen, this just opened up yesterday, you have to go in, and she knew me. So I walked in, and I felt like I was like out of a movie, like, oh.
This is like early,
early. Yeah. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And I met the owner, Greg, and also Bruce. And they were just, we clicked. And I said, I'm a nutritionist. I'd love to help you any way I can. And we have been going strong ever since. So I helped them in the very beginning develop some of the juice cleanses, some of the recipes of the juices. Giving them ideas for little things in restaurant, little things for the foods, and it's been fun. And we have been with each other, helping each other back and forth since the beginning. And when I walked away from there after meeting with Greg and Bruce, the others, and I got, what did I get? I got a collared wrap to go when I was leaving, and I was eating it in the car. Of course, that was a mess because it's a collared wrap, and it's like everything's over. But I almost, it sounds so cheesy, I know, but I almost cried because I was like, thank you, gosh, for this, because it just felt finally something here at the beach, because it just hit home. So I literally go there, they joke me, because I go there twice a day. I go there for a smoothie for breakfast sometimes and some kind of wheatgrass or something like that, and I'll come back for a salad later usually. Sometimes even three times a day, I'll pick up something for dinner. So they're like, hi, Jen, and they know what I want all the time, so I'm there a lot.
And just because I'm now starting more to, I've been avoiding meat for a few months now, and trying to figure out the best way to kind of incorporate like protein and stuff like that. Like, what type of resources do you kind of go to, or would you send someone to go to try to like kind of make sure you're getting
the right nutrients? Mm-hmm. It's because I've I'm mostly plant-based, and I'll say I have, people always ask me, what are you? I'm like, I don't like to put a title or a thing, just like really eat for my, what feels right in the moment. Obviously staying in my parameters, not doing, you know, gross things or anything like that, but definitely in my parameters. But people should start to research how to get complete proteins. People are, I think there's such a myth of you have to have meat to get your protein. And yes, a lot of people will say they leaned down when they ate more of a, you know, paleo or more meat with their meals every day. But, and that's, yes, that's good, but there, I think a lot of people are missing fruit, and they're scared of fruit. Fruit is one of the most beautiful foods on the planet, and they're scared of the sugar of it. And with the fiber that's beautifully in the fruit, you don't have to worry about the sugar as much as people think they do. So I just say make sure you're getting complete proteins, but you're not having to go crazy. There's protein in more things than people realize. I mean, there's so much more, you know, just salads with rice and beans. You get, I mean, I love making rice and beans for my son and I and my daughter when she's home. It's the most inexpensive, you know, perfect, easy meal to make. And I put cilantro with some cut of, you know, tomatoes and some other veggies on the side and some cumin on top, and voila, it's, you know, it's a $3 meal, and it's, you know, and it fills you up. I love it. So we do that a lot. So making sure you get complete proteins, but not people going crazy with thinking, I have to get protein. You do have to be careful. I do find that some people don't combine their fruits properly, and they get into that hole where they become all of a sudden anemic, or they have very low B12, things you have to work walked out for. So, you know, consulting to nutritionists, you know, to make sure you're doing it right.
Yeah. And then thank you again for coming on. Where can everyone follow you? Where can everyone keep up with the journey?
It's on the Instagram. It's Jen Van Horn Health. Also on Facebook. You can also contact you and get my direct number. It's my cell phone number, which I don't want people reaching out to me that way. I have people emailing me at jen@jenvanhorn.com. And also my website is jenvanhorn.com. So you can contact me anyway. I'm taking clients all the time. I just to check it out. It's easy to talk. I mean, I'm like meeting for, you know, 15 minutes for a cup of coffee or a cup of matcha. It's even better.
Yeah. Awesome.
So I love what I do. I can talk about it forever. So I'm happy people reach out to me and say, I love what you do. Let's talk. Let's have a cup of coffee together. Or let's talk when I'm in Bali and whatever, anything. So I can talk about it forever.
Great. And then who's someone that maybe you would like to see on the podcast or hear on the podcast in the future?
Oh my goodness. I'd love to get the Fruitive boys in here. Definitely Greg would be fun in here.
Yeah.
I'd love, he's got so much wealth information. He's all, you know, of course, plant-based. So Greg is, I love Greg. And he's working hard. They're franchising the Fruitives now, so I think it's going to grow. And it's incredible how good the food is, and it's plant-based, and how healthy it is. So I think it's going to start again, just spreading the tentacles out to help heal people.
Perfect.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much for coming
on.
Thanks again.
Yeah.